Alright, hello everybody, JX98 here, and today I'm bringing you a very short informational video on how to build and use the Thrusterdyne Aeronautics Model 23 or the Jet Gun in Black Ops 2. So there's four pieces to this. The first piece is the wires, which are going to be found somewhere in the, you can find them right there. They were found somewhere in the power station. There's two other spots where you can find them, so just kind of look around for them. So, and then you're going to want to come to the town and open that door for 750, and then you put, this is where you're going to build the Jet Gun. Here. All four pieces are going to go here, so the wires are there. So the next stop you're going to want to go is you're going to want to go into the tunnel. Now, once again, I'm pretty sure there's, I think there's four spots in the tunnel where it can spawn instead of three, so, yeah, because I thought there were three, but then I saw the spot that I found in the video, and that was a different one than all the other three. So one can be, like, up there, where I just looked there. Another can be, there's two spots around cars, and then another is way out towards the right of me as of now. If you keep on going, there's a little, like, barrier where zombies can jump through, and it can spawn there as well. So, it can spawn right next to that blue car, I believe. But where I found it was right... Where was that? Where did I... Right over there, right in that little corner. Right here. You'll see. So, that's... As you can see, that's the jet engine, the main piece of the jet gun. Did I call it the jet gun before? I don't know. But, yeah. So, then you're going to have to take this... Hold on, I... Kill these zombies here. You take it back to the workbench here and apply it to the table so we can put our second piece on. Now to get the third piece of the jet gun, you're going to want to go to the cornfield between the farm and the power station. And on the left side of the left cornfield, depending on which side you're going to come, which way you're going to come from. You come from the power station, it's the left cornfield. If you're coming from the farm, it's the right cornfield. Depending on that. So you're going to want to go here, and then you go and go through this little passageway, and you'll find yourself in Nocturne Toten, right here. If you need to know what cornfield to go in, just look up, and you can kind of see a big building in the background, and that's where it is. It can spawn there, and it can also spawn to the shelves on the other side of the Nocturne Toten. And then we can take this piece, our third piece, and put it back onto the jet gun here. There we go. Now the last piece, you have to go to this lamp between the power station and the town, and then head up this little ramp here towards. If you, when you see this little fire, you want to head up towards the fire, and then the last piece can spawn there in the fireplace or on one of the shelves in that cabin. There's also the Bowie knife is there. We're going to apply this to the piece, and we're going to get the Thrusterdyne Aeronautics Model 23. Now to use this weapon, there are two gauges on it, the left gauge and the right gauge. The left gauge is your overheating gauge, and the right gauge is your power gauge. So the left gauge, you have to, it will go up as you use it, the same with the right gauge. When the left gauge hits the top, the jet gun will explode and all the pieces will fall onto the ground. You'll have to take them back to the workbench. The right gauge controls power. Me being an idiot, this is the first time I used it, so I didn't know that the right gauge controlled power. So, I was trying to use it right to zombies. You want to stand back from the zombies, hold down the right trigger, and then kind of walk back a little bit, and then it will suck them in because it'll have enough power. Use it strategically so that you don't make it overheat. That's basically the advice I can give you. It sucks the zombies up and insta-kills them. So that's how you build and use the jet gun. I hope you guys found this video informative. If you did, please leave a like and a favorite. Comment down below if you have any questions about the jet gun. Be sure to subscribe if you want to see more Black Ops 2 Zombies videos, because I'll be releasing a lot more. And thank you guys for watching, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. One thing I didn't point out in the video is that for the jet gun to cool down, you have to have it out in your hand. It will not cool down if you don't have it in your hand. So keep that in mind for when you're using this thing. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I hope to see you guys in the next one.